Welcome back to our show. It's Sister Circle Live. Keisha Knight Pulliam is here.
Yay.
Summer Jackson is here. Selena and I are here. So we've got a whole crew in for our Treen Bean and also Miss Quad. All right, so let's get into it. With the holidays right around the corner, we're all thinking a lot about the time, for giving. But today we want to talk about something that you can't find at the mall or online. It's the gift of being a mother. Aww. We all know that there can be so many highs and lows, but what has being a mom gifted you? What have you learned about yourself, and what have you learned from your children?
My God.
I'm not sure. How long is this segment?
That's what I'm saying, child.
I don't know if there's enough time.
I know.
This is a series.
Yes.
I know, it is.
This is. So, Keisha, amongst us, you have the youngest child.
Yes. My little munchkin. Don't tell her that. She says, Mommy, I'm a big girl, Mommy. I'm a big girl. I'm like, okay.
Yes. How is, what have you learned about yourself? In the last 3 years.
I mean, the biggest thing is that she is my biggest mirror I've ever had. And she keeps me so in the present, because I feel like children teach you how to stay in the present and also how to focus on the important things and the gift and importance of imagination. Because as adults, we get so caught up in our own brain and what's going on and not happening and blah, 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 where children, they kind of bring you back down and ground you.
They do.
So
they do. You have like no choice. Because they're like, hello.
Right.
Like, not over there.
I'm here. Yeah.
Yes. I think now that our older daughter is 13, like it's a whole new world now with a teenage girl.
Yeah. Send it to me at Camp Kizzy. I got you.
I know.
I got you.
We tried to apply last year.
Listen, I think she went this year. What are you doing?
I know. We're gonna get her in next year. Right. But the teenage world is different for me, so I'm trying to navigate that. But I've had some type of practice with my girl serving organization, Sporty Girls, but that has been different. But my 10-year-old has really. Let me go back to when Bailey was 7. I was preparing them to go to the Ryan Cameron father-daughter dance, and I wanted her to wear these certain type of slippers, sandals. They matched her dress, and I didn't get to the store fast enough. I was like, I was so mad because I wanted it to match that dress. She looked at me at 7 years old. She was like, are they judging who's the prettiest daughter?
Oh.
Or are we just going to have a good time?
I was like, the insight.
Lesson. She got you all the way down.
Lesson.
Right. Because at one sense, you know, that old school black moms, don't you talk to me like that. But me, I want to make sure that they can express themselves without feeling like they're going to be punished for it.
Yeah.
And not that I was raised that way anyway, but you see a lot of people who don't allow them children to express themselves.
But you don't understand how those are the lessons that teach them their voice, their power, and the importance of those things.
And the importance of their opinion.
We can't squash that.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
We have to make sure to continue to, you know, nurture it.
Yeah, so with that being said, she got me together in that moment because I was really focusing on, you know, outer things, you know, material things. And she was like, I'm just going with my dad to have a good time. Mm-hmm. And you talking about some sandals?
But that would have been me. I would have been like, listen, they got to match the socks.
I'm that mama.
I agree. Yeah. I would have to say for me, it's just been the love. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's just really, sometimes I look, I'm like, they really love me. This is amazing. You know what I mean? Just the amount of love your children have for you and that you have for them. But sometimes I'm just awestruck because they always lift you up.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
They always, these girls lift me up and I'm just like, oh my gosh, they want me to win and I want them to win. And I just love that about my daughters and their sisterhood and also how they include me in that sisterhood as well. And so I just think that gift of love that kids give you. And like, I looked at my daughter's cell phone. Oh no, I know y'all, don't judge me. The 8-year-old has a cell phone.
I looked at my kids' phones.
I thought you were talking about looking through.
And she just knew, and it's not even that, it's not even looking through it. She had my title in there as Mommy is the Best. That is my name, Mommy is the Best. Like, I'm just like awestruck. You know, it just makes you feel so good because it makes you feel like, you know what? I'm doing something right. I've taught them to love and they're loving me and they're loving the world. So I just look at that, the love that children have, period. Yeah. It's just amazing, so pure.
So pure.
Yeah.
So pure.
I mean, I agree with everything you guys have said. And just aside from the love part, but too, like what you guys were expressing that, you know, just learning, because I have boys, but learning, and then you want to control them. You want, because it's not that you're trying to control them, it's just that when they were babies, that's what we had to do because we were all they had.
Yeah.
So we just were in that same, you know, routine, but you do realize that, wow, you're a person. Yeah. Like, you have a whole ideology of how you want to be in this world. And I have to allow you to have that. But one of the biggest lessons that I've learned, and especially with having a child with autism, is patience.
Yes.
Patience with my children and just really, like, trying to chill. And with myself.
Yeah. Yes.
You know, I'm not going to make all the best choices. I'm going to make mistakes. And that's okay.
Yeah.
And it's not going to ruin your kids.
Yeah. No,
you know, they're smarter than we think.
They're very
exactly.
Resilient.
Yeah.
So just really learning how to give myself a break because I'm so hard on myself about a lot of things, especially about parenting, because I feel like, you know, when I decided to have children, it was kind of like, well, you know what? You have to be very careful with this is a life.
Yeah.
You know, you're essentially you're rearing a child into the world and growing them up and everything that they know. They'll be that adult in the world, so you have to be very, very careful. But no, not really. You just can do the best you can, and that's going to be enough.
That's all that you can do.
Yeah.
So at the end of the day, you know, they are human beings who come into this life with their own purpose, with their own dreams and desires.
Yeah.
And I look at it more as my job is to empower you, to inspire you, and to instill in you all the tools that you will need to be successful.
Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Yeah,
I just want to say, I attribute my growth as a mother, and I will say this openly and candidly, by being on this show. Because the sister circle can make you have a hard look at yourself, by how you present, how you show up in the world.
Mm-hmm.
And because of, you know, the last three years that we've been doing this, I've been able to see myself in a different light.
Mm.
And I knew I wanted to be a better mother. Mm. I was very impatient. I was just, you know, my husband said I'm very, very hard on myself, very much like you.
Mm-hmm.
But having gone to therapy, which I've talked about, that was one of the things when we first sat down, she said, who are you? I'm a kind person. I'm kind to the world. But am I kind to the people that really matter the most?
But are you kind to yourself?
Kind to myself.
First.
So once I started to love me, then I could just be better in every facet of my life. So I attribute so much of my growth as a mother to Sister Circle and my experience here.
Yeah.
That is the truth.
That's real talk. Because it is a low-key meal.
It is.
You got to watch yourself.
And you can't pour from an empty cup.
Yeah. Right. Indeed.
And we as moms, we give, we take care of, we make sure this is ready, the house, we have careers, all of that. But that's another big lesson, is that you have to pour into you so that there's something to give, because they're watching us.
Yeah.
It's not what you say, it's what you do.
That's
what Michelle Obama said.
Yes, wow.
Well, take care of your first child.
That's right. Well, y'all wrap that up with a bow. Let us know how you think by sending us your thoughts at Sister Circle TV. We'll be right back.
This really is a series.
Yeah, it really is. Can't just